Good day, everyone. Today, we want to learn how to use data validation to create a drop-down list. Data validation is used to control or restrict what you want people to type in a particular cell. You can also restrict what they will type in a particular cell. But this morning, we are using it to create a drop-down list. So in this example, I have the name of staff, so I want to create a list where they can pick their position without typing, where they can pick their position. And this is the list of position that I have already. I've created my list somewhere. All I need to do is to select the cell where I want them to pick. I will highlight all the cell. After highlighting, I will go to my data tab. Under the data tab, I will go to data tools group and I click on the button called data validation. When I click on the data validation, I have my settings, input and error alerts. So under the settings, validation criteria is showing me any value by default. That is why you can type any nonsense in Excel and it will still take it. So you click on the drop down arrow, you pick list. Once you have picked your list, you have a box called socks. You can type up this list directly, but if you have your list type already, go and highlight on the list. So you go and highlight on the list, so you select it. You can see I've highlighted on all the list. So after that, you go to your input message and you title the input message instruction. This is the message that will tell them what to do on that particular cell. It will prompt them what we expect them to do on that particular cell. And my input message is pick from list. I want them to pick from list, so I'll put pick from list. So I'll go to my error alert. This is the message that will show to people that are going against my instruction. So I'm titled it warning. So I'm calling it warning. So the error message will be follow the instruction. Follow the instruction. So I'll click on OK. So once you type your name as an employee, you come under the position header, you see a message telling you pick from the list, and you see a drop down list of all the position. So you pick your own position. If you are the MD, you pick on MD. So if you go to the next one, you also see a drop down arrow where you can pick from the list. If you are the HR manager, you click on HR manager. So if you pick anything outside the list, it won't allow you. For example, I type a logistic manager there. Logistic manager. Logistic manager. And I press enter. You can see it will not allow me because logistic manager is not part of my list. If I click on retry again and I press enter, it won't still allow it. It will tell you follow the instruction. That's how to use data validation to create a list in Excel. Thank you for watching our video.